And now we have come to our keynote lecturer, Professor Hisham Al-Askari. Professor Hisham is a real role model to all of us, and he's a real success story that is worth telling. As Africans and Egyptians, we're so proud of his scientific accomplishments and his support of his country and continent. Professor Al-Askari is a professor of Earth System Science at the Schmidt College of Science and Technology at the Chapman University, USA. He came flying all the way from California just to be with you today and to celebrate your graduation. Join me in welcoming Professor Al-Askari.
Good afternoon, everybody. Wow, what a great event, what a great day. Such an amazing audience. Very happy to be here. And I know that everybody in this amazing facility is enjoying their time, and I wish you guys to have a very memorable day in the day which is very important for all of you. Let me start by thanking Dr. Marwa for the very kind introduction, and it's my absolute pleasure to be here today in my hometown, Alexandria, and of course, in the beloved Library of Alexandria. Good afternoon, everyone. Your Excellency, Dr. Mustafa Al-Fei, the Director of the Biblioteca Alexandrina, Your Excellency, Dr. Yasser Rafat, Deputy Director or Deputy Minister for Higher Education and Scientific Research, Your Excellency, Dr. Abdulaziz Khonsowa, the President of my alma mater, Alexandria University, and representative of Ain Shams University, Your Excellency, Ambassador Khalil, thank you so much for your kind words. Librarians, staff, and honorable guests of the Library of Alexandria, and most importantly, the stars of our event today, our beloved students of the African League Young Masters celebrating their milestone graduation. Congratulations to each and every single one of you on your very well-deserved achievement. You guys did it. It's a very important day for all of you. Really, congratulations. I want you to be very proud of yourself, of your accomplishments. I know it was not easy, especially at a time of a global pandemic. Political and economic unrest, and for most of you, being away from your family and friends. I want you to know that I'm extremely proud of each and every single one of you. This is probably my 10th time speaking on this prestigious stage of the Biblioteca Alexandrina, in person and virtually, as a part of different events, conferences, and functions. Yet today's engagement has a very special place in my heart. Since I received the kind invitation from His Excellency Dr. Mustafa Al-Fei and from Dr. Marwa Al-Wakil, the head of the academic research sector at the Biblioteca Alexandrina, I have really been thinking deeply about why am I really excited about this event the most? More than any other event I conducted with the library. You know what? Let me tell you why in all honesty. First, as an Egyptian living in the United States for the past 20 plus years, I tend to carry many identities anywhere I go around the US and around the world. While I identify as a proud Egyptian, I find myself identifying as an African more often. I also connect with my African brothers and sisters the most. Some of them are my colleagues, and many of them are my students. We work very well together. Excuse me. We work very well together. We have published great research, and best part, we became friends. We tended to connect on the spot, as if our hearts intertwined in something really bigger than ourselves. Whether it's over food, soccer games, or the future of Africa, our conversations are always warm, engaging, and quite fruitful. I'm also quite honored to be invited today to witness the graduation of such brilliant body of students from different parts of Africa, receiving their degrees in many disciplines, spanning from nursing, medical sciences, agriculture, engineering, other STEM fields, humanities, and much more. Students that I'm confident will go out to the world and not only do great things, but make the world a better place, one person at a time. I was further impressed to read more about the African League of Young Masters that launched in 2011 as part of the library's youth and environment programs. Today, we not only celebrate our graduates, but also the 10th anniversary of this brilliant flagship program. A renaissance, a pioneer program that saw a need years ago and created a path for it, especially at a time where Egypt is strengthening its African relations, aiming to increase educational, commercial, economical security, and societal ties. A program that saw the future is Africa. A program that opened channels of communication between African students and their Egyptian peers through weekly meetings and other activities during which the two parties share and exchange knowledge and experiences. It's also played a huge role in strengthening the Egyptian-African relationships through producing future ambassadors for Egypt in different African countries and much, much more. And this is the role of the library and librarians in our modern society. A library is more than a repository of knowledge. It's a place that creates opportunities of learning, support literacy and education, and help shape the new ideas and perspectives that are central to a creative and innovative society. And there is no place in the world that was able to do this well than the Biblioteca Alexandrina. In addition to its main role in connecting people to information, it connects people to people. Just like what we are witnessing today in this beautiful celebration, the Library of Alexandria became a community hub, a safe haven. Exactly how the Argentinian writer Jorge Luis Borges described the libraries when he said, "I have always imagined that paradise will be a kind of a library." And isn't that true? Aren't we in heaven? Let's give a big round of applause for the Library of Alexandria leadership, librarians, and staff. But why Africa, and why now? The famous civil rights leader Jean-Louis said, "If not us, then who? And if not now, then when?"
What is Africa? Is it life, the beautiful coasts, thriving cities? It is more than that. It is the people. Our 55 countries have many things in common. Our cultures bind us together. They give us strength and identity. They make us proud. By sharing our knowledge and working together, we are building a new Africa that's driven by investments, by game-changing infrastructure projects, and using transformative technology to change the way we live, work, and conduct business. Using our largest natural resource, our vast arable land, we are making advances in agriculture, developing new industries, creating jobs, and improving livelihoods. Together, we are moving forward on economic integration. By consolidating Africa's significant internal market to foster trade within the continent and with the world, Africa is open for business. We are building the Africa we want. So, what is the continent of the future? The answer is Africa.
Yes, Africa is the future, and Africans are the potential. You guys are the potential. Projection shows that by 2050, Africa's population will double. By 2100, 1 in 3 people on Earth will be African. This means that by the end of the century, Africa, which already has an extraordinarily young population, will be the home to almost half of the young people in the world. According to Brookings Institution data, we are witnessing the beginning of a promising decade for Africa. Through at least the first half of the decade, economic growth across Africa will continue to outperform that for other regions, with the continent continuing to be the home to 7 of the world's largest, fastest growing economies. The collective action among African nations to improve the livelihoods of all under the outline of the United Nations SDGs 2030 and the African Union Agenda 2063 is a clear representation of the shared energy and the excitement around Africa's potential. With business environments improving, regional integration centered around the African Continental Free Trade Agreement progressing, and the transformational technologies of the fourth industrial revolution spreading, never before has the region been better primed for trade, investment, and mutually beneficial partnerships. In fact, this is why we all need to put Africa first. As a matter of fact, as I consider myself an Earth system scientist, most of my research agenda focuses on studies over Africa. My team and I are engaged in innovative work that utilizes satellite Earth observations to address specific SDGs dealing with agriculture, desertification, food productivity, water resources, air quality, clean energy, biodiversity, and climate action. Topics of great need and interest for all African nations. Actually, we delivered the first solar atlas of Egypt years back, and we currently are looking into the implementation of the same idea over different other African regions. As fresh graduates, you are presented with great opportunities and possibly great challenges. Young Africans today are taking actions that not only have an immediate impact, but also determine the future of the continent for decades to come. For Africa to reap the dividends she longed for, it's up to your generation to make sure that the influence is directed correctly and targeted towards relevant issues. Issues that affect not only yourselves, but generations after you. This can only be achieved if you all come together as young people and begin to focus on the challenges before us as a continent. Never has there been a time where the influence can be in your hands like the influence you carry now as young, fresh, and energetic graduates. You have to rise and steer the agenda and not wait for instructions or directions. According to the African Youth Survey 2020, there is a trend of Afro-optimism among young people in Africa, driven by the strong sense of individual responsibility, entrepreneurship, and confidence in an African identity. 82% of the respondents to the survey believe their standard of living will improve in the next 2 years, with 81% predicting technology will be the main driver of their changing fortunes. All of us witnessed the pandemic over the past couple of years and still going on, and we saw how technology has contributed in reshaping our present and will definitely contribute in reshaping our future. You have to channel this energy. You have to capitalize on that collective optimism. That's why, with the fourth industrial revolution upon us and with the rate at which technology is advancing, it is quite crucial that we have enough educated and skilled workforce to be able to drive Africa in this new and innovative direction. Whether it's artificial intelligence, augmented reality, data sciences, or data visualization, the key to your success is your ability to reinvent yourselves and to realign your qualifications with the needs of the future. Purposefully create a culture that promotes the building and shaping of Africa that you want. The change we all want begins with us coming together and developing our own cultural and value system for thinking, planning, application, accountability, collaboration, and most importantly, the idea of a complementarity relationship. And I really mean it, a complementarity relationship. A relation based on the fact that qualities of one supplements or enhances the different qualities of others. I want to leave you today with a quote by the Nigerian writer and the public speaker Chimamanda Adichie. As you graduate, as you deal with your excitement and your doubts today, I urge you to try and create the world you want to live in. Minister to the world in a way that can change it. Minister radically in real, active, practical, get your hands dirty way. Let us all go out there and get our hands dirty. Let us all work together to shape the new narrative of our continent and to be the ones telling our stories efficiently and effectively. Let us work together. Let's complement each other. Let's make sure that our roots are extending deep in our continent. Let's come together to work to address some of the immediate challenges that we all see. I wish you guys all the best in your future endeavors, and I would like to congratulate all of you on your great success and great achievement. Now it's time for you to celebrate and enjoy what you have accomplished.
Whispers of some quiet conversation.